Damion, we've talked about resilience all year in a lot of ways, but maybe resilience was tested on this last weekend at PLU more than any other time. You guys had to bounce back from a really hard performance on Friday when everything that could go wrong pretty much did go wrong, and you did so with the win on Saturday. So just give us your recap of what you saw out there.
Yeah, you know, Friday night was obviously not something that we've been used to in this program for a while. We really got it handed to us by PLU. They're a really good team, and you know, we just, a lot of things kind of contributed to not being at our top performance on that game day, and then we have a short turnaround, and you have to figure out, you have to respond. In a lot of ways, that shorter turnaround is a blessing because you don't have 3 weeks like you would in a normal season to kind of, you know, stew on it. Instead, you have to refocus on the task at hand, and I thought our guys did a really good job of that. We had a great shoot around. You know, as a staff, we got together and made some adjustments that we felt that we could make to give our guys a good opportunity, and you know, it was awesome to see the buy-in from our guys. They brought a much higher energy level, which was difficult for them to find on the first night, but they really rallied together and you know, executed what we wanted to do, made some big plays down the stretch, and PLU is not a pushover team. They obviously are a really good team right now, and you know, it took everything we had in the tank to get it done on Saturday, so I'm very proud of the way that they responded to that.
Talk about what you've learned about this group over these last few weeks and what they've had to overcome, their temperament, their toughness, their character.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, every time we've had, you know, adversity or struggle, and whether it's, you know, a pause because of COVID or, you know, changes in our schedule, just the unknown of what our schedule is going to be, they've really banded together. And, you know, honestly, I've been very impressed with just how even keel they've been emotionally. You know, you don't see as many ups and downs as you could think, you know. So I think that helps us. They've been a very positive group. They've been a very together group. And like you said, that is really their character revealed. And it's pretty neat to see. I think it's a result of, you know, really the whole last year, everything that everyone is dealing with. And there's going to be a lot of good positives that come out of this experience for people. And I think that being able to respond to adversity and being able to not be too high or too low is gonna serve a lot of people well going forward.
This weekend you get your first look at the Blues. Mm-hmm. Just talk about what challenges Whitman will present with the way they play, new coaching staff, new style. Mm-hmm. Give us a little scouting report.
Sure. I've been impressed with the way coach has been able to kind of reload their roster. Obviously, you know, it's a much different looking team than it has been previous years. They graduated a lot of seniors and then, you know, just had some attrition. So I think there's only two faces that are even familiar from last year. So coach did a good job bringing in talent. I think Lum, you know, their starting guard is a really good scorer. I think he'd be, you know, an all-conference consideration any given year. So, you know, kind of starts with him. He's a versatile scorer. He can shoot the three. He can get to the rim. You know, as a team, I think they're playing really well. They, you know, they definitely look different in style-wise than what we've been used to from Whitman. But, you know, I think at this point I have a good feel for, you know, they're going to play pretty solid defense and space the floor, execute their stuff. They've got some shooters who can spread the floor, including their big men, which I think at any level always presents, you know, a challenge for opposing defenses.